Okay, students, can you see the PowerPoint slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you. Okay, so now we are going to learn about the cash flow pattern. Okay, so there are conventional cash flows and a non-conventional cash flows. Okay, so conventional cash flows consist of an initial cash outlay followed by a series of cash inflows. Okay, and non-conventional cash flows, it is a pattern in which an initial outflow is not followed by a single series of inflows, but as alternative cash outflows and inflows. Okay, so what does it mean? In conventional cash flow, the company invests only once. The company invests only once, and which is followed by a series of cash inflows on account of the investment. And non-conventional cash flows include, okay, the company makes the first investment this year, okay, and they start producing or earning revenue for, let us say, 1, 2, 3 years. Fourth year, the company makes additional investment into the same project. Again, the company goes on generating revenues or receiving revenues over a period of another 3, 4, 5, 6 years. Again, the company makes an additional investment. Okay, again, which is followed by a series of cash inflows. So that is called as non-conventional cash flows. Okay, for example, a machine purchased for 1,000 rupees generates cash inflows of 350 rupees each. Sorry? Yes? Somebody is trying to speak? Okay. So, example of non-conventional cash flow. For example, a machine, see these examples are simple examples, okay, which are given so that you can understand. Huh? You don't get like 1,000 rupee machine which will generate 350 for 1 year. Huh? Just for example, for us to understand. For example, a machine purchased for 1,000 rupees. So first time investment is 1,000 rupees. Generates cash inflows of 350 rupees each year for 5 years. So first year investment, 1,000 rupees. And it generates a series of cash inflows, 350 rupees each year for 5 years. In the sixth year, 400 rupees spent to overhaul the machines. Okay, so overhauling is, okay, replacing the defective parts or old parts, okay, and oiling, greasing, and making the machine just look like new or perform like new. We call it overhauling. So 400 rupees spent to overhaul the machine, after which it generates alternative cash inflows of 250 rupees each for 4 years. Otherwise, the machine would have stopped functioning after 5 years. The company made an additional investment of 400 rupees to overhaul the machine, and the company generated additional cash inflows of 250 rupees each for 4 years. So this is an example of non-conventional cash flows. Okay, so if there is any such case, it will be mentioned in the problem itself. Okay. So then cash flow estimate. So while we estimate the cash inflows, okay, so while we estimate the cash inflows, they need to be actual cash inflows. For example, after deducting tax, for example. Okay, so I hope you can understand what is the meaning of net cash inflows. So we need to estimate the cash inflows, and the cash inflow that we are going to estimate has to be net or actual. It means, for example, after deducting tax. So we are going to begin with the ingredients of cash flow streams and how to treat them. And the first ingredient in the cash flow stream is a tax and tax effect. So cash flows, see, remember in the examinations, in the numericals, we'll get, say, for example, 33% tax, 50% tax. Okay, you need to deduct the cash flows. Okay, so always remember, cash flows are to be considered for purposes of capital budgeting or net of taxes, means after deducting taxes. So the cash inflows that we're going to consider to evaluate an investment proposal are net cash inflows, means after deducting taxes. Special, so this all, whatever I'm reading and explaining, we're going to do it, huh? Remember. Okay, so then you should not again ask what happened, why we were, from where tax came, why we were deducting tax. We are deducting tax because cash flows are to be considered for the purpose of capital budgeting are net of taxes, actual cash flows after taxes. Special consideration needs to be given to tax effects on cash flows if the firm is incurring losses and therefore paying no taxes. So in that problem you will get, so this company is incurring a loss, so in that year the company need not pay taxes. Okay, so remember that the tax laws permit carrying losses forward to be set off against future income. So losses can be carried forward against the future income. It is permitted by law. That is why even a loss making firm will not be closed, remember this. So in such cases, therefore, the benefits of tax savings would accrue in future years. So that is the first ingredient, tax and its effect on cash flow streams. Second is effect on other projects. So if the company decides to invest in project A, what will be its effect on other projects which are in progress? So if the project under consideration are dependent on other existing projects, the cash flow effects on other existing projects must be taken into consideration. If you consider the Indian Oil Corporation's plan to invest 2 lakh crore rupees to expand their refining capacity or production capacity. Yes, definitely. Okay, it has its effect on existing project. Already the company is refining refining petroleum products to the extent of 80.7 million tons per annum. How to take it into account, we'll learn in the numericals. Then effect of indirect expenses. The indirect expenses or overheads are allocated to different products on the basis of wages paid, materials used, floor space occupied, etc. If the amount of overheads change as a result of the investment decision, the allocation of overheads should be taken into account in the cash flows. Okay. See, as a result of the new investment proposal, if the overheads change, only then, remember, only then, they have to be taken into account while estimating the actual cash flows. Okay. But if the overheads do not change, so it is written next. If the overheads do not change as a result of the new investment decision, they are irrelevant. So this information will be given in the numerical problem that on account of the new investment project, the overheads are going to increase to the extent of so much rupees. Then you should consider the overheads. Okay, otherwise also there will be information that the overheads will not change as a result of the new investment decision. Then you should not consider the overheads in estimating the cash inflows. See, this each one,
overheads means expenses,
simple expenses. See, the bar it is written, indirect expenses, a bar, overhead means or. Overheads means expenses. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Then this one final I will consider for today. I think this is a longer one. So I'll discuss this in next class. Effect of depreciation. Okay. Each one will definitely will come across each of these ingredients into estimating the cash inflows while evaluating the long-term investment proposals, which you are going to do actually through numerical problems. Okay, and you are going to solve the numericals not with an objective to arrive at the answer, with an objective to understand what is capital budgeting. Capital budgeting is a process of evaluating and selecting long-term investment proposals. So how long-term investment proposals are evaluated, that is what you will understand, remember. Okay, so any questions so far? Anybody who has read it before, then now heard the explanation, something you got confused, you want to ask? Any doubts or any confusion, this is the time to clarify. From students' end, if you have any doubt, ask, please ask. No doubts? Okay.
Oh, sir.
I hope you are sure. Anyway, you can always, you should not hesitate actually, but if you hesitate, you can watch the recorded videos again and again. Only that part. which you did not understand, and everything will be explained. Still also, if you don't understand, you are still enthusiastic to have clarity, definitely you can call me. Okay, so now, as I told you, just to during the classes, though I give plenty of opportunities to ask your doubts or to share something from business news related to subject, okay, usually it is a monotonous class. But still, yes, definitely, since you are online, you are not in the physical classroom, okay, so the connection is not that, bonding is not that strong, okay. So keeping that in mind, I told you that previously, 1 week I played you some couple of songs, okay. So this week what I told you, so those students who are interested can share, okay, what they share actually, already what they have shared. I'm not asking you to develop something new content. Okay, so a video which you have shared in WhatsApp status, Facebook, Instagram, okay. So anything, anywhere, any craft work if you have done, painting you have done, you want to share. So you can share it here now, exactly 5 minutes time we have, 1 minute. I will leave early every class. Okay, so anybody who is taking initiative today to share something. And definitely, see, I will pause recording. You need not worry. It will not be recorded.